Listen, thank you for the time and the opportunity to speak. Tonight I'm going to be referencing and talking about U.S. Code, Section 704 of the 1996 Telecommunications Act and Section 6409A of the Spectrum Act. Both are examples of what's called black letter law. Black letter law was passed by the U.S. Congress, and I'm going to ask you to consider the actual words of this code with fresh ears and an open mind, so you actually listen to what it said, because it's quite different than what the wireless industry fables and propaganda tell you that it says. For example, the code never mentions or references health effects. Never. Black's Law Dictionary from the 9th edition defines black letter law as one or more legal principles that are fundamental and well settled. Black letter laws are the well-established legal rules that are no longer subject to reasonable dispute. Black letter law is contrasted with legal theory or unsettled legal issues, such as radio frequency issues. Very unsettled. The courts are all over the map on this issue. But the black letter law of the 1996 TCA tells us exactly what our local officials' responsibilities are. Only federal legislation passed by our U.S. senators and U.S. representatives has the authority to preempt local officials' duties. Not FCC regulation, just federal law. Particularly when those duties pertain to the protection of public health and safety, lower courts' judges' interpretations cannot change black letter law. California state and local elected officials, therefore, cannot simply be dissuaded from or decide not to regulate something when they are charged with such duties, such as you are right now. You have all taken oaths. You have all taken oaths to uphold the federal and the California constitutions before you took office. You must protect your citizens, and this will help you do it. California elected officials are prescribed by the U.S. Constitution. They have taken oaths, and therefore any activity not preempted by the black letter law of the TCA is then regulated by the local officials. Anything the TCA did not mention remains under the authority of California officials. Therefore, the regulation of any and all operations of wireless facilities, once again, that word is operations, because we're going to jump right now to the law and read what it says. It says the limitations are for the regulation of the placement, construction, and modification of personal wireless services facilities by any state or local government or instrumentality thereof. That means that when you look into the congressional record in 1995, the wireless industry wanted operations on that list and did not get it. It has remained with the local community. You have the ability and the duty to regulate both the hours of operations and the power levels of these cell phone towers in order to protect people, because you can consider environmental effects for that, and you must consider that and health effects. Thank you.
Thank you. Matt Mullen.